Hello everybody and welcome back to the Glasshouse Productions YouTube channel. Today, I'm actually by myself because Charlie is off partying somewhere, so just me doing this tutorial today, but nevertheless, I'm here to bring you some value, bring you some knowledge, and hopefully you'll learn something. So the question is, today, what lens is the best lens to start with? Now, let's say you're in a position where you've bought a camera, respect, nice one, you've splashed the cash a little bit, okay, and you've just started, and you're looking to purchase a lens in order to take some cool photos, some cool videos. Burning question is, what lens do I buy first? Now, if you have a kit lens, which is an 18-55mm or something like a 70-150mm, you're on the right tracks. Those are good lenses to start with because they're cheap, they have bigger range than most. So you've got 18-55mm, so you've got a lot to play with in between that, and you can experiment and see what kind of size lens would suit you. What lens you pick first and what lens you actually splash the cash on first is going to change your photography game and your filmmaking game forever, because it will always be the first lens that you started with, and you will learn to develop a technique around that lens. I remember the first lens that I bought that wasn't a kit lens was a 24mm 2.8 pancake lens. Now, I don't have that lens anymore, but I remember that lens because it has developed my style. It's actually a huge game changer. So firstly, you need to ask yourself, what are you going to be shooting with these lenses? Now, we shoot people. Please don't take that out of context. Our work is predominantly around people. So music videos, weddings, commercial-based work, gigs, festivals, you know, it's all about people. We don't shoot landscapes. I'm awful at shooting landscapes. I don't shoot wildlife. It just doesn't interest me. I don't do sports or anything like that. I've dabbled in long exposure photography, but frankly, it's not my passion. My passion is shooting people. So you need to ask yourself, what are you going to be using this lens for? Because that should determine what lens you actually need to buy. Now, budget is always something that comes up when people ask me or Charlie, what lens should I buy? Or what camera should I buy? And budget is always the first thing we ask, because, you know, if you are not serious about it and you've got like, I don't know, £50 to spend on a lens, I'd say don't bother. Unfortunately, in this game, if you buy cheap, you buy twice. And we have learned that the very, very hard way, by buying cheap stuff, cheap gear, and it didn't work out. For example, the 24mm, I spent money on that. I think it cost me £120. And don't get me wrong, it's great for a beginner, but if you're actually trying to build a business, or you're trying to take it really seriously, that 24mm is not good enough. So I ended up selling it and buying the lens I'm shooting with now, which is an 18-35mm 1.8 Sigma Art lens, which is incredible. But if you actually are looking to make money out of using this lens, like if you're in a band and you want to make your own music videos or something like that, you know, you got to take it really seriously because this affects your career. If you're a business that's looking to take their social presence really seriously by getting into photography, you need to take this seriously because your entire reputation is actually down to whatever you shoot. And if it looks like garbage, then people are going to assume that your business is garbage. It's harsh, but it's true. And the same goes for any photographer or videographer out there that's actually looking to make money out of the equipment they use. If you have garbage gear, it's gonna speak volumes about your business. Now, I'm not saying you have to have the most expensive gear. That's just not true. In fact, gear shouldn't actually affect the films you create. But at the same time, if you are serious enough to charge people for it, you should at least have gear that's good enough. If you're serious, you need to spend money. And you will reap the results. It will look sick. That being said, if you are a hobbyist and you just do this for fun and it's just something you're passionate about, yeah, I actually do have advice for you and give you, I'll point you in a direction that will help you. But those are two completely different ball games, and we will talk about both of them. So let's talk about the lenses that I have used and that we have here in the HQ and what I think suits what. And at the end of the video, I will give you my recommendation for the one lens I think you should buy that everyone should buy. So let's talk about the kit lens. Actually is a killer lens to get with your camera. The first lens you get is pretty banging. The jump is big, but probably more so to the trained eye. The 18 to 55 mil does a stellar job, and you can achieve some really good looks out of it. That being said, it's probably more of a hobbyist lens. If I saw a professional rock up to a wedding with an 18 to 55 mil kit lens, yeah, I would judge them pretty severely, but that's only because I know that they're charging for it, and so that's not justified. If you're a hobbyist, 18 to 55 millimeter kit lens with whatever camera you get, that's a pretty banging choice. In fact, any kit lens is good. It's better than nothing, right? Some kit lenses are much better than others. So the one that comes with the Fuji X-T2 is incredible. It's a very, very powerful lens. But the ones that come with Canon are kind of okay. They're not very sharp, and you know, they could be a bit better. But the Fuji one that I've used was actually very, very nice, very smooth. It had a very good build to it, and so, you know, Fuji really have taken their kit lenses pretty seriously. So the 70 to 200 millimeter 2.8 lens. So this lens is incredible. Probably one of my favorite lenses that I've ever used. It is incredibly beefy, it's very heavy, but it produces such an incredible image. Very, very good if you're far away and trying to get in close, especially with a crop sensor camera. That 2.8 really creates such an incredible depth of field. Plus, the compression of the 200 millimeter, if you were to go all the way in, creates such an incredible blurry background and really separates your subjects from the background. Like I said, it's great for events, but it is hella heavy, and it's also very, very expensive. You know, you're looking at spending about £1,400 minimum for a good 70 to 200 mil. There are some other options out there, but like I said, you pay cheap, you pay twice. That's just the kind of experience that I've had. But would I recommend it to a beginner? Absolutely not. It is for professionals. This thing is massive, you know, in price and size and weight. I would not recommend it for a beginner. Sigma Art 85mm 1.4. This lens is sick. Because it's a telephoto lens, you've got that incredible blurry background, which really separates the subjects. And you've got the 1.4 as well, which is like, oof, absolutely gorgeous. That being said, it's not a versatile lens. It really isn't. You've got to have such a specific use for it. Like, portraits, wicked. You went and filmed a festival with this thing, you're going to struggle big time, because it's quite zoomed in, man. Like, a beautiful lens, but you're stuck at 85mm. That's pretty damning, really. Fantastic lens, creates incredible images, but it's not very versatile, so I would not recommend this to a beginner. 24mm. The pancake lens I used was a 24mm. Now, I've used other 24mm, like the L series, and they are gorgeous. They are really, really nice lenses. Would I recommend it to a beginner? I would recommend the pancake lens to a hobbyist. Because it's so affordable and actually creates a fairly decent image, I think that other people could really benefit from it. There is no right or wrong in filmmaking, but that's my opinion. That lens is not good enough for commercial work. So, would I recommend it to a beginner? Yeah, but I would explore your options, because I feel that, for me personally, there are better options. The 10 to 22mm Canon lens is a very, very wide angle lens. It only works with crop sensor. This is like the Casey Neistat lens. It's his go-to for vlogging, or at least it was. It's a really cool lens, really cool. I think it really depends what you're trying to shoot. Landscapes, I think it's pretty decent for that. If you're a vlogger, oh yeah, that stuff's gonna help you out big time. But for portraits, I just don't feel like it's gonna be very effective. You know, if you're filming a festival, it's gonna be sick. For a wedding, I don't feel like there's much depth in it, and you know, it depends what you're trying to get into. Really, it really does. Like, for like action videos, I think it's perfect. I think it's such a wide angle lens, you're not gonna miss a thing. But for like music videos or anything like that, it starts to look a little like a GoPro, which kind of looks a little unprofessional. So for a beginner, yeah, but it would depend on what you're doing. The 18 to 35mm 1.8 Sigma Art lens. This has got to be one of my favorite lenses ever. It's so versatile and it's so sharp. This lens is quite expensive, but so worth it. I have been through so many cameras and that lens has stayed with me on every single one. I'm using it right now. It's a very, very good lens. It stays wide, but also when you go for the 35, you compress it enough to make a nice depth of field with that compression. The 1.8 is super, super handy because you get those beautiful bokeh balls, and also you can whack out to 18 and get every shot you need to. I think it's an incredibly versatile lens, but the issue is that it only works on crop sensor. So if this worked on full frame, then it would be the best lens for sure. But regardless, I highly, highly recommend this lens. Maybe not so much for a beginner. I feel like it could be more versatile, and so I recommend it, but I don't at the same time, as it's very expensive. The Nifty 50, this is what we refer to as the Nifty 50, as you know, it is just, well, it's just the Nifty 50, mate. It's absolutely banging. This lens is honestly incredible, and if you were to get the 1.8 version, it's actually very affordable. So for that reason, it is something I would recommend to a hobbyist. You can create beautiful, beautiful images with a 1.8 50mm and not spend more than 100 quid. Now, if you look on eBay on a Sunday night, you'll see tons of lenses going for such a cheap price. So I would highly recommend looking on eBay on a Sunday night. If you're in the UK, that's particularly, but I'd highly recommend you check that out. That 50mm is incredible. Yes, you are restricted to just 50mm as it's a prime lens, so it's not incredibly versatile, but if you're only interested in taking like portraits or super sharp shots with a nice blurry background, then you gotta check this out, man. It's pretty banging. And last but certainly not least is a 24 to 70mm 2.8. This lens is amazing. I've shot an entire wedding. In fact, I've shot tons of weddings with just this lens. Tons of events, full stop. If it is my go-to lens, it is just the best. Now the reason being is for events and for run and gun shooting, it's just so handy to have that ability to go in nice and tight and then go really wide, and then everything in between. It's just incredible. You get this beautiful blurry background. The depth of field is just incredible. It's so sharp, the one we use. The Tamron is just amazing. I have seen footage and I've seen photos from the L series Canons. They are also very, very good. In fact, I can't really fault a 24-70 that I've seen. I'm hoping we'll eventually move on to the Sigma Art 24-70mm. Just beautiful. Would I recommend this to a beginner or someone looking to get their first lens? Yes. I have a really good friend called Sam Morris. He has a killer Instagram, so you should check it out. But he was proper getting into photography and I saw that he was doing a lot of drone stuff. And he approached me and said, what is the best camera and lens that I should buy if I really want to step up my photography game? And I recommend the same thing to everybody, and it is Canon 6D secondhand and a 24-70mm secondhand. Now the reason is because the 6D is still an incredible camera, even though other cameras have come out since. It really holds, and the 24-70, you honestly won't need another lens for a very long time. It is just an incredible setup. Now, I recommend this to a lot of people, and not that many people go and buy it because, wow, it's hella expensive, you know? It's not cheap. But then, if you're looking to get into it, you have to be serious. Now, he actually went and bought it, which is the first time that's ever happened. Like, I recommend it, they never reply to me. But Sam actually went and did it. Now, he has built an incredible portfolio by actually splashing his cash and getting good gear. And I think, actually, a lot of photography and a lot of videography really falls on, are you serious enough to actually spend a lot of money to get incredible results? And he was, and I was, obviously, because I've got all this stuff. But it is just taking that leap of faith and going, I am into this, I do enjoy it, I want to see if we can take this further. So for that reason, my go-to recommendation for a first lens for a beginner looking to get more serious would be the 24-70mm 2.8 Tamron, Canon, whoever you're with, whatever manufacturer you want to purchase from. I highly recommend that because you get all of the amazing features and it's incredibly versatile. So I hope this helps and I hope that you can take something away from this and that it's slightly educational. Again, I shoot people and I shoot events, so this is like my recommendation for that kind of shooting. So thank you guys so much. If you want to check out any of the lenses we spoke about in this video, go to the description box down below and you will see all of the links to Amazon, and it will take you there and take you to some good deals. And if you purchase from those links, you'll be supporting us, which will be greatly appreciated. So thank you very much. If you want to check out our website or check out our socials down below, there are also links there. And if you want a tutorial and we haven't done it yet, please leave a comment and say, Reuben, Charlie, I'd love to see this tutorial. Make it happen. And we will say, okay, no problem. Subscribe to join the first 1,000 subscribers on this channel. Unless you're watching this in the future and we already have more, which would be pretty cool. But if not, thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope this brought you some value. We will see you next week. Cheerio.